Every year in the Alaska waters, for more centuries than are recorded, the salmon return from distant seas, remembering in some incredible fashion their unmarked path through the bays and inlets, fighting their way up the rivers to where they were born in numbers so vast it seemed the supply could never diminish. The creatures that fed on them took only what was needed. Could not be noticed, for the waters truly appeared alive with fish. In the first two decades of the 20th century, enormous man-made fish traps began to appear. Soon they blocked the bay and river entrances in such solid numbers that fewer and fewer salmon got past them and up the rivers to breed. In the Indian villages where salmon was the bread and the flesh and the fruit that the land could not supply, the natives anxiously stared at the heavens and their totems. They performed ancient rites to persuade the mysterious spirits of the sea to let the salmon return again at the time of the annual spawning. But the rites and the ceremonies were all in vain. Year by year, the harvest of salmon grew smaller and smaller, until by government decree, the number and location of the fish traps were severely limited to prevent the salmon from being completely wiped out. With fish no longer free for the taking, a modern age of piracy began. So by night, men were forced to guard their fish traps to protect them against floating thieves.
Jim. It's a boat.
Gas, you got lost in the fog, you got lonesome and thought you'd drop in on us. Take your pick, Roy.
Well, we ran out of gas.
You ran out of luck.
Well, we're not trying to steal any fish.
Then let's have a look at your tank.
Now, don't be suspicious, Joe. There's a 5-gallon can over by the brailer. Joe'll show you. Gas you were after, Roy.
Yeah.
I'll take that gun you're carrying.
Oh, just a minute.
Yeah, I'm boarding a tank for you.
Oh, no, we can do it. Thanks, Jim. We'll pay you back.
Yeah. How?
Out of gas. If I hadn't have been here, you'd have let him empty the trap.
I seem to remember an Indian kid named Joe Matt and I picked up a few years ago. He ran out of gas, too.
Now, you got it wrong, Jim. I got lost in the fog.
Oh.
Matt, you and me, we had some pretty good times before he left.
Yeah, quite a team, weren't we?
Working together, having our own trap. Why'd you let the government close it down?
They had to close it, Joe. There wouldn't be any more fish. Matt couldn't have done anything about it if he was here.
So why are we staying? Every time we haul in a fish, everybody in the cooperative has to vote.
Well, you could have gone with him when he left, Joe. Why didn't you?
He didn't ask me. Yeah, we don't have the fun we used to with him gone. Wonder where he is, what he's doing.
Well, I don't know the name of the town or what bar he's in, but the liquor's bourbon and the girls are blonde.
Like Nicki?
Different.
Sorry. Funny, I thought he'd be back for the salmon run.
Yeah, I was kind of hoping the same thing. Sure miss it, crazy. Always trouble, but lots of laughs. And he's probably still looking for that street paved with gold. No, he won't be back. Maybe it's better.
About the night work.
You better?
Mm-hmm. Did you have trouble?
Am I worried?
Maybe.
What? Why, if anybody'd set foot on them traps last night, it'd have blasted a hole in them big enough to swim through. Hi, Joe.
What? Yeah, sure.
I thought it was Matt who taught you how to lie. You're brave, aren't you?
Ain't afraid of nothing.
Impossible. Would you mind?
Hey, Jim.
Right.
Yeah, I was lucky. Just lost a little blood.
What happened?
I left Tim and Dan on one of the traps.
They must have been hiding on it. We never knew what struck us. When I came to, they were gone.
And so were the fish. You want to bet by now you'll find them at Williams' cannery? Those fish belong to all of us in the cooperative. Anybody willing to come with me and get them back?
Now, wait a minute. He'll say he bought them, which he probably did. So what's it going to get you but a long boat ride across the bay?
We won't have to go that far. Williams is in the hotel.
Hold it. Now, you listened to me last year when I said form a cooperative and build our own cannery.
Yeah, we listened to you.
All right, then let me talk to Williams alone.
Jim, listen. One of these days, while you're still talking to Williams, you'll wake up to find your traps empty and your head bashed in.
What do you want me to do, Nick? Shoot him?
Well, at least it's a way to stay alive.
Last night it was a way to kill. Two guys I used to steal fish with.
And there was trouble last night.
Wait for me upstairs.
Well, I figured you'd all be here to bail me up in a net and drown me in the harbor.
Nah, just me.
Drink?
Sure.
Most of you fishermen won't drink with me. And they ought to know that no matter who buys or sells it, whiskey tastes the same.
I guess you figure that goes for salmon, too, huh?
Depends on who cans it. Why don't you let me take over that one-lung cannery you fishermen built and run it right?
We don't like the way you run your own. Look, Williams, last night some of our traps got emptied. This morning there's smoke in your cannery chimney. Says your boilers are going full blast. How about that?
There's no brand name on those fish, say they're yours. As long as you and your cooperative refuse to sell me fish, I buy where I'm able.
Well, we'd still sell to you if you'd pay enough to make it worthwhile hauling in the nets.
I've got to make a living, too.
The other canneries make a living. They pay a fair price.
And why don't you sell to them?
Because they're too far away. We'd spend all our time hauling.
So now you're trying to run me out of business.
Now, look, maybe we can work out something. So what if you take half the pack? We can't handle the load we're catching now. We've got to ice it down. We're losing time. We'll pay a cost and a profit.
My cannery work for the fishermen?
Yeah.
Fishermen work for my father. My father didn't work for fishermen. Fishermen work for me. I don't work for fishermen.
Aren't you going to drink your drink?
Nope.
Jim. Letter for Nicki. Came yesterday. I'd say it's from your pal.
I'll take it to her.
settle anything with Williams?
Nah. Look what you got.
Where from?
Seal Bay. Looks like Matt's scrawl.
It is from Matt.
How is he?
He's fine. Send you his best. Says he's fine. He learned to stay in one place. He says he'll be back in a week or two.
Back in a week or two, just like that after a year, huh? I wonder if he figures nothing's changed.
Jim, let's get married now,
huh? What? Hey. What else did he say in that letter?
Oh, you know, Matt, he says a lot of things.
Yeah, but what else did he say in the letter?
He says that since he's been away from me, he realizes he's been away from the only thing he cares anything about.
Oh. Well, we're still gonna get married like we planned and not before, see?
Are you sure you want to marry me?
I am, but what kind of a guy would I be if I didn't give you a chance to be sure, too?
Hmm? Well, it's not that. That's not... Jim.
I wish I was the willow on the riverbank, 'cause I'd never have to make a living then, hustling up the stream and down the stream.
Save it, Kelly. I've had enough of that to last me for the next 6 months, too. Let's go.
Six months slow.
Matthew Kelly.
Better count my money first.
The thieves are on the other side of that door.
You sure?
Well, it wasn't me that poached seals.
How was I to know there was a Coast Guard boat hiding just around the bend?
Sign here. Get out of here and stay out of here. What a way to talk to the new Matt Kelly.
I won't be back. Scout's honor. But now I'll thank you for that beautiful example of my own handiwork made for my lady love. Oh, it's not the gift that counts. It's the thought behind it. Oh, the starlight is dancing on the ripples, and the soft evening breeze will soon begin. The stream again. Oh, I wish I was the willow on the river bank, and I'd find the peace of mind I'm looking for. Afternoon, Mr. Wycroft. Smiling as usual, I see. Thing of beauty. To look at her, you'd never know she tangled with an iceberg. Look at this, you would. $920. What'd you do, jack up the compass and build a boat under it?
$920.60.
Well, who's complaining at a time like this?
$253.
Correct to the penny, Mr. Wycroft. And as soon as I make my first catch,
$920.60.
A Wycroft. You're a boatman. You know what it means to a fisherman to be without a boat.
$920.60 right now.
I'll be back.
Oh, I wish I was the willow on the river. I would
Place your bets. $253 worth of even. $14 red and even. $253. What a ride. $23 red and odd. And odd. Very, very odd.
What's left to believe in? The man of your sterling character ends up scrounging around the dock.
Things can go bad for lots of people who deserve better, Matt.
Never had that trouble. Mine's always been where to spend my money.
Looks like you tossed away a good hunk of it right here.
That's not tossing it away.
Maybe. You know, it's no wonder they call a boat she. No insult intended, but you ought to get more use out of it. You look pale.
Gold. Found so much of it, never came up above ground except to sleep.
Well, then I guess there's no chance you scrounging around with me.
Verne, I got principles. Never have anything to do with a man as crooked as myself.
I heard you've been keeping steady company with quite a few of them lately.
Just practicing staying in one place. I'm settling down. Man, fishing boat, and this woman. As soon as I get hold of a mail order catalog, I'm gonna order a fireside and some slippers.
Better go slow on that order. Been a lot of changes around here since you left.
I'll change them back.
Maybe you will. If I can help.
Can I afford it?
bill from Wycroff Boat Repair.
Hey, Matt!
Hello, Matt.
Hi, boys.
Hello, Matt.
Matt.
How are you?
That's right, Jackson. No tears of happiness. Just a big, beaming smile. Where's Nicki? You know how you ever spawned her, I'll never know.
Gone to South America, I hope.
Soon as she comes in, tell her I'm upstairs cleaning up. Oh, is Jim's door unlocked?
Yeah, and his clean shirts are in the middle drawer. I want everybody to have a drink. Celebrate my return. Pop's treat.
Slicker. At least you're glad to see me. No? Well, that makes it unanimous. Get out of there. I want to use it. Come on. Come on, Slicker. Come on. Come on, Slicker. Slicker, you take your bath down here. Think a lot of me. What happened? Jim tell you they caught me trying to make fur coats out of some of your friends? Oh, I know. It's the shirt, huh? Slicker, I'm ashamed of you. Jim doesn't mind me using his shirt.
Matt.
It's only fair. You saw me without a shirt.
Well, you had no right to come in without knocking.
Well, I used to bathe you when you were a kid.
Well, it's different now.
Yeah. Sure is. Here, let me.
Oh, I can do it.
Let me do it. Let's do it.
Matt?
Yeah?
Matt, stop.
fixing the necklace.
Well, fix the necklace.
All right.
Matt, look, there's something that you've got to understand.
But the last time I went roaming, you decided you weren't in love with me. You could never love a man like me. And the only person in the world for you was Jim.
Yes.
And why didn't you marry him?
He wanted to wait.
He's smart. He knows the net's no good if it won't hold the salmon.
He wanted to, I didn't.
Nicki. Were you that scared of me coming back?
I wasn't scared. That's Jim.
Hi, Jim.
Hi, Matt.
Long time.
Yeah.
Glad to see me?
Well, I don't know.
How's Joe?
He missed you. So did I.
Which one of you stole the most fish while I was away?
What are you trying to do? Get her to change the inscription?
Yeah, just about succeeded till somebody blew the whistle on me.
Well, that's tough. Better luck next time.
I appreciate that coming from you. I made it.
My clothes fit you all right?
Oh, yeah, fine.
Nice. I'm sorry about not wearing the same size shoe.
Shoes I can buy.
Nicki, you can't, huh?
Don't want to.
You might have to.
Oh, it's like a boat. One with time and care and proper handling. You get it broken in, right? You don't want to go off looking for another one.
If you let a boat go on the rocks, abandon it, another guy pulls it off and puts the pieces together, he's got a pretty good claim for salvage, hasn't he?
That vessel didn't look to me like any major repair job was done on it. Got a little trouble with the other one, though. Oh, a repair bill to Wycroff down the coast. Figured I might sell you my half of our trap.
Matt, there's nothing left to sell. The government closed it down along with 30 others.
They think they own the ocean?
Up to 12 miles out, yeah.
I'm getting out of here.
But Nicki stays.
Maybe.
She stays.
I said maybe.
Well, maybe I'll tell her I'm willing to get married right now.
That's pretty good. While I'm away, you win my girl, and you lose my trap. Then you tell me I can't take her away and I can't make a living here. Boy, you want to win the easy way.
Well, I'll see if I can get you into the cooperative.
Thanks.
Well, Matt, you know, with these guys, there better not be anything fishy but the salmon.
Scout's honor. Mm. Jim, you pick up 1,000 while you're by there safe for Wyckoff.
I've got 1,000. There's 50 in the drawer.
He wouldn't even take 250.
What happened to the 250?
Charity.
Mm. Well, I'll see what I can raise on my boat. Meantime, send him the 50. Your credit's no good around here. They remember you.
Why, Jim, you didn't tell me.
Nicki's birthday, tomorrow.
Oh.
Well, I better go mail Wycroft that dough.
Hey, Matt.
Yeah?
Things have changed around here, you know.
Things haven't. You have. A guy who used to make even me look like a rosy-cheeked cherub. Why, Jim?
Found my first gray hair, I guess.
My father died when he was 80 years old. Every hair is black as mine. You got a sister? Here, give her this.
You make him?
Yeah.
Then maybe you know my brother. He made one just like him in jail last year.
Never associate with disreputable characters.
Hey, Matt! Joe!
Hi. What's this lie I hear about you turning straight? Hi, fellas.
Matt?
Hello, Matt. How long are you gonna be around this time?
Well, I'm anchored here permanently. I'm even gonna work with you. Come on, Joe. Help me buy something.
Oh, I saw you both, Matt. Glad you're back.
Thanks. Like to look at a ring.
Sure.
What's it worth?
To you, Matt, because you're a good friend, $100.
With a friend like that, I don't need an enemy.
50?
Well, you're being real friendly.
I'll get your box. Thanks, Matt. Jim?
Greco. Glad you came by. There's something I want to talk to you about.
Hope it's not what we think.
Matt.
We don't want him in the cooperative.
Why?
You should remember better than us what he was like. You were his friend.
Well, I was mixed up in everything he was. You trusted me. Any regrets?
No.
Well, why don't you give him the same chance?
Jim, things are just beginning to go okay now.
And that's just the way they're gonna stay. I'll give you my word. Matt'll behave himself.
All right, Jim. We listen to you.
Okay.
Jackson.
Hello, Andy.
Happy birthday, Miss Jackson.
Oh, Andy. It's beautiful. Oh, so sweet of you to remember me. Hi, look what Andy just gave me. You can tell he made it himself.
Must have taken him months.
Kind of crude for Indian work, isn't it?
I don't care if it's crude.
Well, I don't mean it that way, honey. It's just that the kids don't do the fine work the way the old men do. Here.
Jim. Oh, Jim, it's lovely. Thank you.
Birthday.
My turn.
Matt.
That evens the score. I'll get ahead at the birthday party, man. Let's go.
Don't forget, it's 8 o'clock.
Do I ever forget?
Speaking of forgetting, did you send that 50 to Wycroft?
Come to think of it, no, I didn't.
Matt.
Hi, Matt. Hi, Richie.
me, ma'am. Know where I might find a man by the name of Matt Kelly?
Well, yes, he just left with the fleet for the fishing grounds. He'll be back later today.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Keep the net tighter. Watch our sidelines.
We got more fish than the cannery can handle in one day. After you load up, we better head for the ice field.
Right. You're next, Matt.
Hurry it up.
After you're loaded, we'll head for the ice fields and ice them down.
Okay. But it don't compare with stealing them.
Now, maybe the boys agreed to it, but they ain't crazy about it, Jim.
What?
You ought to watch what he says and does.
Let's go, Matt. Dig it deep.
Man deserves a fair chance.
That's what he'll get. No more, no less.
We better whistle down some of that loose ice before we get any closer.
Take over the wheel, Joe.
All right, that does it. Let's get out of here.
to give Jim a little thrill.
Yeah, better not, Matt.
Worst lion you ever were. I did it. Hit the whistle by accident. Talk to you. Later. Now. I know, $920.60.
But plus expenses.
Look, I spoke to my pal about the dough. So let's go into the hotel and have a drink till he comes, huh?
But who pays for the drinks?
Be my guest. Come on. Come on.
We listened to you, Jim. We gave him a fair chance.
He's out. That's right, Jim. It just won't work. We've decided.
I'll tell him.
No, I wanted him in. I'll tell him.
Here you are, Mr. Wycroff. Drink up. Pop's treat. Jim, I was just telling Wycroff here he had nothing to worry about. You take care of everything.
You better tell him I lost the boat I was going to borrow on.
Well, Kelly, that's that.
Jim, I'll make my boat half yours. The cooperative needs it now. How about borrowing from them?
You're not in the cooperative anymore.
Whose idea was that?
Well, it doesn't make any difference. The idea's right.
Jim, I gotta have the money.
Not from them. Or me.
Wyckoff knew exactly where to find me. You'd do anything to keep Nicki, wouldn't you?
Pop, I need some dough.
No. You can cut your own throat if you want to, but I'm not going to hand you the razor.
Wycroft, wait a minute.
Stay on his boat.
I know where to get the money.
Don't get on his boat, I said. Didn't I tell you to get on the boat? Come on. Somewhere. And if they don't, they'll know I was last seen with you.
save Wycroft. But only because even sharks won't eat another shark.
So where are we going?
To get your money. Sure you can afford it? I can't afford not to afford it. How much do you need?
A little over 1,000.
Ooh, you don't come cheap.
That's why I'm a bargain at any price.
I'll find out about that tonight.
Tonight?
You got other plans?
No, I got Wycroft on my boat. I'll pay him off and take him back to town, and then I'll...
Baker will take him back. Matt, don't try to run out on me. I'm not like Wycroft. I don't collect in cash.
Happy birthday, baby.
Happy birthday, Nicki.
Isn't that lovely? Mm. Thank you, Dad.
Now make a wish. Now for the specialty of the house.
No need for this extra glass.
Matt will be here, Pop.
For which birthday?
Where is Matt?
I don't know.
Jim, let's go outside. I want you to tell me what happened to the boat.
There's nothing to tell, Nick.
The men seemed to think it was Matt's fault.
No, it was an accident. Could have happened to anybody. Slipped and grabbed the whistle cord, that's all.
And you lost your boat. Did Matt just let it go with that?
No, he offered me half of his.
Well?
I didn't want it.
Why?
I don't want it.
Is the accident the reason that he's out of the cooperative?
No, it was a mistake to take him in the first place. Men don't want him.
Not even as your friend?
Well, their friend, too, Nick.
You want to get rid of him?
Oh, Nick, look, let's forget what I said the day the letter came. Let's get married right away, huh?
What's changed you?
Well, because Matt's no good for you. That's reason enough.
Remember what you said the day the letter came? You said, what kind of a guy would I be if I were afraid to give you a chance to be sure? Hmm?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, Jim! Jim!
What?
At Bailey's Point, offshore, there are boats drifting. No motors, no lights.
Get a hold of Walt and Erickson. They're in the hotel. We better get out there. Hey, if Matt shows up, go ahead and cut up that cake, huh?
Get him aboard. All right, boys, that does it.
Thank you.
cash drop for you. Get out of here, quick. Bert! Hey! Hey, Bert!
Better get outside, Roy.
Late for a social call, isn't it?
We found a couple of your boys on our traps tonight. We thought we ought to bring them back to you.
Asks, I suppose you'll say they were dead when you found them.
I don't think anybody will ask. If they do, tell them this is just the beginning.
You're right, Kimmerly. It is just the beginning.
Matt's boat is here. He was out there stealing fish.
Let's give him the same treatment we did the other two. Then deliver him to Williams.
I sent Matt down the coast to get me a price on a new boat.
Then why didn't he take Joe with him?
Well, I guess he figured he was needed here. Right, Joe?
Yeah, that's right.
That's right, boys.
Come on, let's get some sleep. Where you been?
I had to go down the coast. Take Wycroft back.
Why didn't you take Joe with you?
Don't you listen to yourself? You said he might be needed here.
How'd you pay Wycroft?
He trusted me.
You're lying. You've been on the traps with Williams.
That's not what's bothering you, Jim. It's Nicki.
Hey, come on, you good.
Get out of here before somebody kills you.
Well, here's your chance.
what's this all about, Jim?
Doesn't concern you.
But maybe it concerns us, huh?
Why don't you tell them what happened?
All right, we're fighting over you.
He wanted me to leave without you.
That's what I told him.
You've never given him a chance. None of you. He never will.
You lied for him again, Jim.
I had to. They'd have killed him if I had.
Hurt bad?
It'll get better. But this won't here. I tried, but you see, they don't want me. Let's get out of here, Nicki. Tomorrow. It's the only way we stand a chance.
How long would it last, Matt?
Why should it ever end? Kelly.
How good is my credit? How good is an empty fishnet?
Williams, I want to get out of town tonight.
Without your boat, you got the money?
Neither. No matter how many fish you steal, you'll never lick them as long as their cannery operates.
That's my business.
I've had to make it mine.
Good idea. Burn the cannery.
Not me. Use one of your own eggheads.
That'll keep them busy while we empty the traps.
Williams, tonight, I figured that if I...
Figure tomorrow.
What'll we do if they come out after us?
Wait for them. With these, we can put enough powder in this harpoon to blast them out of the water.
Pressure on the thing?
That's all.
Where's Joe?
I don't know.
Anybody seen Joe?
Hey, Jim. They're emptying our trap.
Greco, take charge here, will you?
Hi, Jim.
Eddie, round up some of the boys and get on Tom's boat.
Where's Matt?
I don't know. Better not be where we're.
Come on, let's...
Thank you.
Hey, Verne. That's foul. Give me a hand, will you?
Harpoon gun, Matt.
Get me in there. I think I can get a shot at that harp gunner.
Right. Keep the light on him.
Get him.
No, Matt's boat's too fast. We'd never catch him.
Jim's back.
Sure. How bad was the cannery?
A few were burned. Jim. Joe's dead.
We fished his body out of the water with a knife in his back.
Was Matt out there?
Yeah. I shot him, Nick. I don't know whether I killed him or not. Can I use your boat, Greco?
Sure. I'll go with you.
All right. Tom, we're going north. You go down the coast. We're going to bring him in.
Nicki, I had to. I couldn't help it, honey. I didn't have any other choice. I couldn't help it. I had to.
I know. Jim didn't hit you.
No. No, he missed as usual. So he told you I was out there. Pack your things. We're getting out of here.
I'm not going with you. Whatever it was that made me want you, well, it's just gone now. Jim covered for you all the time, even with me. Get out of here before he gets back from William's place and kills you.
You come with me. You can travel light. Joe will pick up your things.
Joe won't.
For me, Joe will do anything.
Joe's dead. They killed him when they burned the cannery.
They killed him?
Jim didn't miss.
No, it's bleeding pretty bad. I could use a drink.
Yeah, I'll get you one. Sit down.
Me, Matt. Give me some help.
Did you find anything out back there?
Found out plenty.
Are you going to tell me or keep it a secret?
They're out after us.
We've got nothing to worry about with that harp gun on the bow.
What is it?
Boat coming. It's Jim.
Better run for it. We're faster.
The ice will keep us hidden.
He'll see us as soon as he gets close.
Before that happens, we'll use the harp gun.
Verne, we've done enough damage around here already.
Almost. This job together should finish him.
I told you once about that principle of mine. Never have anything to do with a person as crooked as me. I got that principle back, Vern.
Who was that?
Not sure.
Vern, I guess we weren't really meant to be on the same side.
You don't even know what side you're on. So you're no good to anybody. Not even yourself.
Yep.
Matt's boat.
Greco, give me the rifle.
Yes, he did care a little.
He cared enough to get himself killed for us. It's not how a man begins that counts, Pop. It's how he ends.
Let's have a drink. To Matt. Pop's treat.